Michael.
I'm sorry. I didn't get much sleep last night. Getting a prestige on Call of Duty is hard work, you know. Especially when you got some wisecrack on your headphones saying how Friends is way worse than the Big Bang Theory.
What a noob.
You know, there's no peer pressure for you to go over your limit of 2 drinks tonight. Right, I'm just saying, when you go to uni, where there's probably going to be quite a few drinking games,
you'll probably only last probably 1 or 2 drinks.
I don't know. I've got a meeting tomorrow with the man that could end up being my support worker at uni.
We'll just give them what they're expecting and sign on for dotted line.
Go on then. I suppose I better get some practice in before I step into the firing line. Seriously, I can't name all of the doctors in order. William Hartnell? David McCoy? Sylvester McGann? David Tennant? Tom Barker? Tom Cruise? Seriously, how do you drink so much and not muck up one word when ordering another drink?
Lots of practice. Mate, don't think it's a good time to go to sleep.
I'm not, just resting my eyes.
It's all time for college already. I think you should take me home.
Okay. Michael, that's my bed.
Do you only do it when we still have a sound effect at the door? When did you get here?
Walk past me.
Alright. Yeah, we were drinking last night.
I had a couple with my brother.
Ah, I only know two things. One, that is going to be your best mate. And two, you'll fit right in here. So, you want to come to uni?
I was thinking about it. I was thinking I might take a gap year.
Gap year? I took a gap, yeah.
Excuse me, mate, would you mind not lying down in our goal?
You have got the whole bloody...
Don't suppose you know how many euros to a pound there is, do you, mate?
Hey? Where do you think you are, mate?
France?
Right, there's an old guy with socks over there, a young family down by the pier there. This is England, mate.
Ah. Must have overslept and got the ferry back. Still, it wasn't a bad holiday. Anyway, where do you think you're going a gap here, if you don't mind me asking?
I've got a few ideas, really.
I was thinking maybe I could start off in...
Well, you seem like a smart kid. So, I reckon you'll do just fine, yeah?
You see,
I've got a friend who's at uni. He's now going into his first year for the third time. He's got a stack load of debts and a failed poker business where the player wins more than the table.
Really? What do you say the name of his business was again?
It's www.failpoker.com.
Well, he sounds like one of these people who does maths or biology or something like that. You know, one of those subjects that he didn't really enjoy and just ended up drinking it away instead. But on the other hand, you could get one of those dorks who does ICT or something like that, who just spend the whole day geeking around in their room. What was it you said you did again?
It was ICT.
I digress. Still, I reckon he was just one of those people who drank far too much in his first year.
Make that two.
Well, my point is, are you really passionate about ICT? Do you genuinely enjoy it?
Yeah, I spend all day on the computer.
Well, I suppose we're all guilty of Facebooking on the toilet every now and again. How much of a party guy do you think you'll be?
Not much of one.
Trust me, you'll do fine here. I mean, if I can become a fourth year psychology student sidelining as a support worker, anything can happen.
It's not just that. There's another reason why I don't think uni's for me.
What's that?
I'm afraid.
Well, the seagulls are fairly placid this time of year, and you can just avoid the beach while they're in heat.
No, I'm afraid that I won't be able to go to uni because of my Asperger's syndrome.
Asperger's syndrome? Never heard of it. Still, we had one guy coming in a few years back. Harry Shanahan, dyslexic to boot. I mean, this poor beggar couldn't even spell his own name. And now I hear that he's writing his own self-help book, although the proofreading costs are still through the roof. Jane Gatlin? That's not you. Right. Michael. Well, you got distinction in most of your units, so that's all good. To be honest, your GCSEs aren't amazing. But to be honest, I've seen people come into this uni far worse.
Really?
Well, don't tell anyone, but this one kid last week, £500 bribe to get through.
Really?
No. Anyway, where do you see yourself in 5-10 years?
Owning a business? A website?
Business? I'll still do that. Tell you what, in 10 years' time, why don't you hook me up? Apparently, right, the owner of Google has short-term memory loss. I mean, why else would he create such a popular search engine?
Yeah, but I could hook you up in 10 years without having to go to uni.
Well, that's what my parents said, and now my mum owns a CD strip joint, and my dad's the main act.
Yeah, I'm different.
You're absolutely right. You are different. You've got this Asperger's syndrome, and look how well you've done. What you need to do is come to uni just to see how far you can go. I mean, tell me, how are you going to start up this business? Where are you going to learn all the skills necessary?
Reading.
Well, you need a sound plan. You need to know the inner workings of business. You need insightful information before you can put any money in. And all of this stuff you can learn at uni.
My relation's got a business. He could help me start it up.
Well, just make sure it's not this failpoker.com fella, yeah? Now, if you'll excuse me, I need to go take a quick pebble dash. Well, I'll tell you what, if you do change your mind, chances are I'll be around here for the next 4 years anyway, so I can sort you out with all the support you need and let you know where the easiest girls are, yeah?
Yeah, cheers.
My little brother. So, how did the interview go?
We did fine. It'll fit right in here. If TV's taught me anything, there's always one brother who's smart and ugly, and one who's pretty and thick.
Well, unfortunately, me and Michael have to get a train. But anyway, it's nice to meet you. I'm Johnny.
Colin.
Anyway, you ready?
Yeah, let's go.
Very good. Should I do for a typical get down on one knee, or should I hide it in something?
Hide it in something? You could use it as one of the little pieces in Monopoly. Then when she passes code, here comes Johnny, will you marry me?
That's not too bad, actually. What other ideas have you got?
You could play sorry. Hide it inside one of the little plastic men. Then when she gets a circle saying sorry, you go, sorry, will you marry me? I do feel like there should be a sorry in there somewhere.
What's the point of you in general? I don't ever think you would help.
So, did Mum tell you?
What?
Sarah's moving in, if she accepts. Mum agreed to it before we went to uni.
But your room's right next to... Why hasn't Mum asked me about this?
I'm sure she's going to get round to it.
I feel like I'm being pushed out of this place.
You've been lucky staying here for so long. I mean, no job throughout college. You know how much time Mum's given up to help you out?
No.
I think for this family it'd be good if you did go to uni.
Ah, you found it. Well, how you doing, my man?
Yeah, good.
Good enough? Excellent. Well, I found you some good student accommodation. Do you want to go see?
Yeah, I can't wait.
Excellent. Now, let me tell you about the warning signs of STDs. And that is why you should never sleep with girls called Stacey. So, yeah, don't worry about this. Basically, what's happening is you're gutting all the houses at the minute, getting rid of all the asbestos. Yours is done last week, so no need to worry. This is you. What do you think, mate?
What's it like inside?
Better than the outside, let me assure you. I mean, you know, just lick a paint.
Yeah, I see.
Lick a paint. Probably redo that window, I suppose. Lick a paint. That's lead-based, but we can ignore that bit. Anything else?
Which room's mine?
Well, on that, you're a third to arrive, so you've got a choice of two. Yeah, mate, I'm sorry I can't come with you, mate. I've got to dash off. I've got to see a girl about a movie, yeah? Enjoy yourself, and if you need me, you know where to get me, yeah?
Cheers.
Thanks for all the good times. You've done me well. Thanks for all the help with those long, late study sessions. I'm sorry, but it's time I moved on to some stronger stuff. It's university. I can't go for university drinking you. I'm sorry. I will miss you. Come here, baby. No. It's not fun drinking like this. It's Freshers' Week. I've got to get a group together. I can't drink alone tonight.